Alrighty, folks. Wanted to come back and show you what we have with our pieces of chicken. What we've actually created is some of the finest chicken that ever walked the face of the earth. So let me just make a few slices off here so you can see what I'm talking about. This cooked all the way through. These were the chunk chicken breast. They cooked all the way through. They are just beautiful. Just beautiful little piece of meat, crispy outside. Even these ones here have the crispy edge outside, cooked all the way through there. Yummy, 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 yummy. Perfect on a plate of hors d'oeuvres, a board.
Evening, folks. Grandpa Greenwald, old man with a pan. Well, we haven't quite opened up our kitchen, but we borrowed some space for a few days while it warmed up. So we're going to do some cooking tonight. What I have is a couple of pre-seasoned, they came from the supermarket season, chipotle pepper, some sort of chipotle chili pepper, I forget the exact name. So anyway, my intention is to like quarter these things or third them, so I have maybe three pieces out of each one. I think I'll do that, three pieces. Then I'll flour them using this as my moisture, what's already on the chicken as my moisture, and we'll deep fry them, see what we come up with. These are a little bit goopy. So I'm gonna put on one glove and see if we can make that work with one glove on. All right, let's see what we got. I didn't feel like getting all goopy today. It just, for some reason, didn't want to get goopy. That's awesome. So we have six chunks of chicken breast, good seasoned chicken breast. Let's do that. Let's see what we're going to add today. I like that AP rub, but I haven't given this oil dust much of a fair shake. So let's sprinkle a little oil dust in there. And that'll be our main seasoning. That'll be our main seasoning for the chicken, will be the oil dust. See how I mastered not using this hand? It was a tough one, but I was able to master it. I'm gonna go ahead and turn it up. We want this oil to be at 375 degrees when we drop the chicken in. It's gonna, the cold chicken is gonna pull that down a little bit, but we're gonna put it in at 375. So. Alrighty, I believe we're up to temp there. I'll start out with a small one first. I suspect with this flour, some of this flour is going to leave when we dump it in. So we'll see what happens. Perfect. Wow. It just started right out boiling, right out. Good deal. Get another little. And I'll put one more little one in there. Actually, it makes no difference. It's the equivalent of a chicken breast in the pot. All right, one more. I knew that batter was going to come off of there, but that's okay. That's okay. We'll see how these things look when we cut into them. Now, looks like fried chicken breast to me. All right, let's. That looks like it didn't need much regrouping time, which it didn't. I should have shook the flour off a little better. I'm going to turn that down. It's cooking at 375. Let's bring it down to 350 and see if we can stretch that cooking time out a little bit. All righty, that's about. Let's see what we. That's about it there. I believe they've cooked. I believe they cooked really, really well. So there you go. We have some chunk chicken pieces. We can pair that with about anything that we wanna put it with.
Alrighty, folks. Wanted to come back and show you what we have with our pieces of chicken. Well, we've actually created some of the finest chicken that ever walked the face of the earth. So let me just make a few slices off here so you can see what I'm talking about. This cooked all the way through. These were the chunk chicken breast. They cooked all the way through. They are just beautiful. Just beautiful little piece of meat, crispy outside. Even these ones here have the crispy edge outside, cooked all the way through there. Yummy, 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 yummy. Anyway, just some beautiful, beautiful, beautiful chicken. If you recollect yesterday, we floured that real good, but the only moisture we had was in the seasoning. So when we dropped it in 375, the flour kind of just walked away real quick. So I was kind of hesitant or disappointed when we took it off, and I think I made that pretty clear. But when you get inside and you start cutting it for this chicken for a salad, I'm gonna stop cutting that with that knife, but on top of a salad, again, the crispiness is just absolutely amazing. So I am gonna call success on this cook. Made a fine, fine, fine piece of salad chicken. Golly. Wanted also to remind you of what we seasoned this with. That was the Texas dust, oil dust seasoning, and that's what we added to the flour. So that was our primary seasoning for this chicken. Really delicious. Being hesitant here because I'm down to the end, and I know that will take a finger right down to the bone also. Dunsky.